Welcome back. In this video, we're going to be taking a look at taxes in NetSuite. And while that subject might seem a little daunting, especially if you're in the United States, once you understand the structure of taxes and some of the terminology, you'll find it's actually relatively simple. So let's take a look at this. So the first sort of tax category that you have is called a tax nexus. And the definition of nexus is simply any kind of connection point between multiple things. So if you had four streets coming together into an intersection, you could consider that intersection as a nexus. And you could kind of say that the tax nexus is a sort of a connection point between the tax collecting body, let's say the IRS, and you as a business, which are responsible for making sure certain taxes are paid. So you have that tax nexus at the top. And in most countries, the tax nexus is actually going to be the country itself. So if you're in Canada, for example, the nexus is Canada. So it's pretty straightforward and it's even simpler after that. So you can think with that. Where things start to get tricky is in the United States. It's almost like because the US has so many different tax codes and categories that it really wasn't feasible to have the nexus be the whole country. They kind of needed it to be at what it is, which is a state level. So in the United States, California, for example, would be a tax nexus, Texas would be a nexus, etc. And as I go through the rest of this example, I'm going to stick with the United States for two reasons, really. Most companies are using the US dollar, at least more than any other currency. And then secondly, it is the most difficult. So if you can understand how this works for the US, it's certainly way easier dealing with any other country. So in our example, we're dealing with a tax nexus, and let's say it is California. So if tax nexus is at the top, down from that, we have what's called a tax group. And a tax group is really, if you drew a map of California and you broke it into a bunch of little pieces, each of those pieces would be a tax group. You could consider that a tax group is like a county, and sometimes it is exactly a county. Sometimes it's bigger than a county, includes multiple, sometimes it's smaller. It really just depends. But the stable point is it is a piece of the nexus overall. So in our example, if we're in California, let's say we're in the tax group called Blue County. And then down from the tax group is what's called a tax code. And really the way to understand this, so we're not just, of course, in a county. Our business doesn't exist in the whole county. We're in a specific place. So let's say we're in Smallville. We're in a town called Smallville, and that exists in Blue County, which is in California. So the nexus is California, the group is Blue County, and then the tax codes are all the basically the individual taxes that can be applied. So in that particular case, the tax codes might be the California tax overall. That might be the county tax for Blue County. Smallville might have its own city tax. And then you might have as many as 5 or 10 additional taxes that are really dependent on the location you're in and the various laws that are present there. Some states have a lot fewer taxes, and some states like California have just an outrageous amount of different tax codes and lines and things like that. So again, in our particular example, we are dealing with at least the state tax and the Blue County tax, and then potentially one for Smallville and any additionals. And that's where we get the nexus at the top, the group, and then the various tax codes that apply to that group. Now, it's important to understand that while the tax codes are within a group, they're not exclusive to that group, right? Because if you have a state tax is a tax code, that state tax is obviously not only applicable to Blue County, it's going to be applicable to all groups within that nexus. So there is some kind of overlap between the tax codes and the tax groups. And as you take a look at this in NetSuite, you're going to start getting a little more familiarity with what these things look like. The last category I need to mention is what's called a tax schedule. And that's really simple. It's either taxable or not taxable. So it's a yes or no, pretty straightforward.
Now, if you're finding this video helpful, be sure to hit that like button and subscribe to see future videos. And if you really want to dig into this subject, not just taxes, but really accounting in general, be sure to take advantage of my NetSuite for Accountants course. I'll include the link up above and down below. And in that course, I really cover a wide range of subjects, everything from invoicing, billing, bank reconciliations, month-end closes, the whole nine yards. So if that's something that's interesting to you, be sure to take advantage of that course. And now that we understand how tax nexuses, groups, and codes work and really what the differences are, let's take a look at this in NetSuite.
So I'm here in the home dashboard and I'm gonna come up here to setup and I'll go down to accounting. And if I scroll all the way to the bottom here, notice we have this whole section on taxes. And I'm actually gonna open up a few of these, but instead of clicking on it from here, I've already gotten them open on here. So the first thing that we talked about was a nexus. So let's click on that. And we can see for our current NetSuite instance, all the different nexuses that apply. So you can see we've got one for Texas, Pennsylvania, Ohio, and down the list. So this isn't all states per se, but it's the ones that apply to our business in this case. And of course, if you needed to make a new nexus, you could simply go over here and create a new nexus. So once you've got the nexuses, down from that, we've got tax groups. So if I open up that list, you can see you've got the name of the tax group here, and you can see the first initials are indicating where is this group. So if the nexus was, in this case, we can see Alaska at the top, then it's got Alaska, and then the actual group is right behind that. And you can see just for Alaska, we've got this entire list. And if we go to the next page, this is also all Alaska. And if we go to the next one, it's only on the third page that we finally come to tax groups that are outside of Alaska. So again, a huge amount of groups that we're dealing with. You can see the total 4,500 at the top here. And that's the tax group. So remember, that's just a subsection within the nexus. And if you want to look at the tax codes, you're going to want to click on one of these tax groups to see what those tax codes are. So let's just open up one at random. We have, this is Alaska Whales. So if I click on that and I go to this particular tax group, you can see in this case, we've got two tax codes here. One is for the state overall, which in the case of Alaska, they don't have any state tax, so it's 0%. And then the city of Wales also has its own tax code. So this is actually a pretty straightforward one. We've got two, one for the state, one for the city. Let's actually go back to the tax group and let's open up one from California so you can see the difference. So again, I'll just do this at random. Let's say this one from California, El Dorado County. And we can actually see there's a few different El Dorado County ones, and the last few letters there are indicating more specifically what is that tax group. So let's just open up the first one. And if I go to that tax group, and in this case, we can see there's three. So there's a California tax. And in this case, we have a county tax for El Dorado, but there's not a city tax. And then at the top here, there's an additional one. I don't know what this particular one does, but you could certainly look up California EMSR and find what is that tax particularly applying to. So those are the tax codes. You can also click on the city and zip code, and it will show you all of the different zip codes that exist within this particular tax group. So sometimes it's only one zip code. In this case, we have dozens of different zip codes that fit within this one particular tax group in El Dorado. And you can also come up here to tax codes as a list, and you'll see every single tax code that exists for your particular NetSuite instance. So you can go through that whole list again, because they can overlap with the tax groups. So they're not completely housed within the tax group. They do have an overlap between them. So we've now gotten a bit more familiar with the nexuses, the groups, and the codes. So now the question is, if you were setting this up for the first time, how would you go about doing this? What would be your first step? And the first step would be really setting up the nexuses. So you would come over here and you would click New Nexus. If you're in the US, you simply go through and you pick the exact state you want to be in. Once you've selected, once you've created really all of those nexuses, let's say there's 10 states, you make 10 tax nexuses for each state. At that point, you would then come up here to setup. You'd go to accounting. We're gonna go back down to the bottom there. And you come over here to use state sales tax table. So if you click on that, it brings you to this page, and you would do this for every tax nexus. So for all 10 states that you need, you would basically come in. So let's say Alaska is one of them. You would add Alaska and you would come and you would hit save. And by doing this, it's actually going to import in all the tax groups and the tax codes that apply to that nexus or that state. So it actually just does all that work for you. It's very straightforward. It pulls in all that information. And once you have that, you now have not only working nexuses, but also groups and codes. And at that point, you can, of course, come in here to setup accounting, and you can come to setup taxes if you click on that. And here you can see, so we've got multiple countries here. You can come to, for example, the United States, and you've got various settings. You've got tax agencies, home tax codes. You're able to make additional modifications at this stage if it's relevant for your tax purposes. So let's say you've got your taxes all set up, everything's in the system. The next question is, how do these things get updated and when do they get updated? And while you might think that you would want to have these things set on automatic, in most cases, you actually will go with a manual approach, which is basically you want to once a year, after you've closed out the previous year, you'd want to go through and make sure that everything is manually updated tax-wise for every tax nexus. And the reason you'd want to do that, even though you could technically automate it, is because in many instances, businesses will have the ability to have tax exemptions. So let's say you were in an agriculture business and you had for your particular tax group, you might have had one or more tax exemptions. You would want to be able to manually create those and have those just exist for the entire year and not just automatically get updated to the correct percentage, which is not applicable to you. So the way you would manually make modifications to the actual tax rates is by coming up to tax codes. So you'd come here and let's actually go to one of these other tax codes. If I scroll down here, we've got other, and if I click on that, let's say we're in Texas and whatever this particular tax is, right, it's for 0.5%. We knew that based on our business, we are exempt from this tax. So I would come over here and I'd go to edit on this. I would open up this tax code and I would actually manually set this rate as being zero. And I would save that. And that would allow me to make sure that my taxes are properly reflecting the exemptions that I have or that my company has. And again, you would generally have the year go by, you would close out the year, and then you would do any updates needed manually to your tax rates based on any exemptions that you would have provided to you. Now, that's your average company. In some cases, you might have so much business, so much revenue in different locations that it's simply not feasible to have to deal with all of those tax codes, groups, etc., especially not on a manual basis. In that case, you would want to look at something like probably Avalara, which is really the dominant leader in the tax realm, and especially in the United States. So Avalara would allow you not only to automate the system, so you're not having to do manual updates and entries, but also still be able to put in the exemptions that are applicable to you. So be sure to check out their website if you think that that's something that your organization might need. And that's it for taxes in NetSuite. I'll see you in the next video.